Hello, we are using a Lubuntu Live distribution that can be used in every desktop without requiring any installation. We start by opening our web browser and going to the book web page. Copy the link for the file archive. Open a terminal. Download the file archive into your folder by using the command wget. Unzip all the protein XML files except the one that ends with the entry label. Return to the book web page and click on preprint. Go to section XML processing. Assuming that our information need only concerns human diseases, we have to process the XML file of each protein to check if it represents a human protein. For performing this filter, we can again use the grep command to select only the lines of any XML file that specify the organism as Homo sapiens. We get in our display the file names that represent a human protein. Now we need to extract the PubMed identifiers from these files to retrieve the related publications. We can execute a grep command. The output is a long list of publications related to protein P21817. To extract just the identifier, we can use the got command. In some systems, the xmllint command needs to be installed. We need to execute apt install got. Copy and paste the grep and got command. Not always the XML elements are in the same line, as fortunately was the case of the PubMed identifiers. In those cases, we may have to use the xmllint command, a parser that is able to extract data through the specification of a XPath query, instead of using a single line pattern, as in grep. In some systems, the xmllint command needs to be installed. We need to execute apt install libxml2utils. In the case of our protein XML files, we can see that their second line defines a specific namespace using the XMLNS attribute. If we are only interested in using local names, there is a way to avoid the usage of local name for every element in a XPath query. We can identify the top-level element in our case entry and extract all the data that it encloses using a XPath query. The new XML file now starts and ends with the entry element without any namespace definition. Now we can apply any XPath query on the auxiliary file without the need to explicitly say that it represents a local name. The output contains only the data inside of each reference element. To extract the identifiers, we need to apply the tr command to split the output in multiple lines and then the got command. The output is again the long list of publications related to protein P21817, but now extracted using a XPath query. Thank you for watching this video.